Western country to approve a coronavirus vaccine with its regulator clearing Pfizer and BioNTech vaccine. That is the big story that we are getting you at this point of time. It is an emergency authorization that is coming in, clearing way of a vaccine deployment expected to play a significant role in global effort to halt coronavirus. Pfizer, along with its German partner, have said in November that relying on novel technology called messenger RNA, this was 95% effective in final analysis of clinical trial data. United Kingdom clears this vaccine. Milan, I just want to know one thing. Is the vaccine going to be available by next week to the citizens of the United Kingdom?
Well, definitely. After the emergency use authorization, that is a tool in the hands of the government who can ascertain whether or not the vaccine should be given to the citizens or not. Now, since United Kingdom has already approved its emergency use authorization, one will see that this vaccine will help inoculate at least 20 million people of the United Kingdom. So that is a good news for the country who has seen a very high death toll because of COVID-19 cases. UK also had to go through a shutdown. Of course, the vaccine makers, after they announced the efficacy more than 95%, as you said, in late stage trials, they moved ahead faster than other vaccines to get emergency use authorization. Its meaning is that the government approves distribution and production of the vaccine to ramp it up so that it is available for people quickly, and now it will be given to the masses. Every common person in UK, remember, United Kingdom had also said that they will make these vaccines available for free, but we'll know more after more statements come in from the UK
authorities. Yes, so by next week, every person in United Kingdom will have access to a vaccine. That is the big breaking story coming in at this point of time. The Pfizer and BioNTech vaccine is officially cleared. It's an emergency authorization by the UK regulators. Milan, just, you know, taking the story back home a little bit and contextualizing it to India, to the race for vaccine in India continues as well. Pfizer and BioNTech was one such probable contenders, but the experts say that the storage of this particular vaccine may not be conducive in the climate in India. If you could just tell us a little more about where India stands as far as this particular vaccine is concerned, does it look any more of a possibility than before for us to have this particular brand of vaccine?
Well, certainly, Chaiti, you put it rightly. The vaccine that Pfizer has made is to be stored at minus degree temperature. So it's to be stored in minus, below minus 8 to minus 16 degree cold storages. Now, at this point, when we asked the health ministry of the Indian government, they have said that they are in talks with all vaccine manufacturers. So be it Pfizer or be it Moderna, both these vaccines that need to be stored in sub-zero minus temperatures. But the cold storages that India has at this point, we know experts have said that other vaccines that need not be stored in such cold temperatures are more conducive for the infrastructure that India has as part of its mass immunization program. But certainly, since the Indian government has clarified in a press conference previously that they are in talks with all vaccine manufacturers, we'll have to wait and see if Pfizer could be able to procure some doses for other countries as well, because as and when the citizens of UK will be given the vaccine, which is about a week from now, we'll have to wait and see what are the talks between the Indian government and the United Kingdom government on Pfizer's vaccine procurement for mass populations within our country as well.